Here we go. Check it out. Word up. Yo. Check it. Check it. Check it. Yo. Fox Street between Longwood Avenue and 156. My block I grew up in, mostly blacks and Hispanics. The crew that caused mad panics called BNS, acronym for beating niggas silly. The evidence smoke blunts forced tobacco dispersed on the floor from a Philly. Chilly weather called for a first down vest, goose or leather. Perfect attire to conceal weapons better. Some prefer 38 tecs or knives big enough to sever. Next to the point of making a brother's neck cock back like a pest dispenser. Half of the block were apartment renters, the other half lived in shelters. Drug dealers Unscrew, the metal face of the base of a light pole. So stash a paper bag with a crack stash and some cash, so that when Jake came to frisk and harass, too bad Jake, go back to your precinct. Now I know you be mad, but on the way home from school just wanted my Nintendo control pad. I got 2 hours before dad comes from home for work. Mama let me play and watch cartoons before doing the homework. Yo, video games in those days was better than being permitted on a first date to put your hands up a girl's skirt. Mama's cool even if I wanted gelatin or dessert before dinner, she wouldn't consider that a bad decision within her. My daddy, the discipliner, very often off to work, being the breadwinner. Mama left winger, papa right winger, got together for worse or for better, but trying to make it work. Both of them said whatever, 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 whatever.
Tiene razón.
Tiene razón.
Yo. A los niños.
You see, Pop got with Mom out of conviction that he wanted his first son to have a dad, not like his dad did to him. That left grandmother and my father fending. My dad started working at the age of 7, helping his mom eventually, street vending. A ladies' man like any other young man who may have slept with many chicks without a wedding. But there was no telling that the one lady, my mom was the real one, finally got pregnant. Now Pop, out of moral obligation, did the settling. Came to the United States legally in the 60s. Finally brought my mom and my oldest bro to the borough so thorough. The South Bronx, and it wasn't long till my dad's headstrong nature made my mama his biggest hater. Both of them became players, but tried to do the right thing. Even on Sunday, went to church together to say their prayers. They were fighting for something greater. The kids are important. We can divorce or separate later. Even we gotta get on each other's nerves more than on a nerve catheter. They said, screw it. For the kids, we gotta stay together. Both mom and pop said, whatever,
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 whatever, whatever, whatever. Yo, this concept of staying together for moral duty to the family came with its disadvantages, understandably. As a child, I could sense in the home the tension and agony. My mom would be walking on thin ice so tactfully, while my dad was ready to point the finger and criticize anything that seemed like blasphemy. But mom caught extreme fits that acted irrationally. I can't front. In the ghetto, we were good financially, but not happy. Caused me to seek family and brothers that were gangsterly. My dude's Adoni, my rotten hand man E, living on the fourth floor, smugs and another dude who I respected and considered hardcore. But what if my pops would have walked out on me and my mom? Would if there have been more calm or an environment more similar to a sitcom? Would I still have a need to go create bonds with those with illegal arms or with ghetto charm? The most skilled fortune teller reading my palm would have probably told me nay, cause either way I wanted to do stuff my way. Yo, that's it, that's dictatorship. Got me pissed to the point to never submit, rather resist until the point of getting chased and wanting more space, more than spacious. But on flip side of shit, when mom was left alone for a little while, it didn't change my style. Yeah, sure, the absence discipline made me smile, but I still wanted a while. But not in order to run away from an angry home, but this time in order to explore Rome. Possibly for the purpose of gaining respect among the other lost souls. So either way, more likely than not, would've still probably ended up a hood mofo. At least dad taught me and my bros, not every chick is a hoe. You gotta hold it down with a female if you have a kid, that's how it goes.
Whatever, 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 whatever. That's what mom and pop said, whatever. Yo, we gotta do whatever to stay together. For the kids, yo, we gotta stay together. Whatever, whatever.